Hey everyone, I'm Pratik, a dentist and specialty doctor. And in this video, we're going to be looking at the most widely used form of caries classification, GV Black's classification. If you want to see more educational content similar to this, please make sure to subscribe to the channel. And if you find this video useful, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. GV Black's classification was developed over 100 years ago. However, it's still the most commonly and widely used method to classify caries lesions, and by extension, restorations. It describes lesions based upon two factors: the tooth involved, and the surfaces on that tooth that are affected. There were initially five classes that were developed, however, a sixth modification was added later on. By having this almost standardized way of describing caries lesions and restorations, it works as a very effective way of communicating and passing on information between dentists, on dental records, and potentially even with patients. So if you look at the classes, we have class one. A class one lesion describes pit or fissure caries, or a restoration, on molars and premolars. It also includes the occlusal two-thirds of the buccal and lingual surfaces on molars and premolars, and the lingual surfaces on anterior teeth. Class two describes a proximal lesion, so mesial or distal, on a posterior tooth, i.e. a molar or a premolar. Class three describes a proximal lesion on an anterior tooth, so again, mesial or distal, but importantly, it is a lesion that does not involve the incisal edge. If a lesion does involve the incisal edge, then it falls under a class 4. This is a lesion that affects a proximal surface of an anterior tooth and includes the incisal edge. We also have class 5, and this is a cervical lesion on any tooth, so it doesn't matter whether it's anterior or posterior, molar, premolar, whatever it may be. If it's in the cervical region, it falls under class 5. And then finally, we have class 6. So class 6 is a lesion that just involves the incisal edge on anterior teeth, or involves the cusp tips on posterior teeth. So there, we very quickly looked at the six classes under GV Black classification. To summarize, we have class 1, which is pit and fissure, i.e. occlusal lesions on posterior teeth, or the occlusal two-thirds on buccal and lingual, and the lingual surfaces of anterior teeth. We have class 2, which is mesial or distal on posterior teeth. Class 3, which is mesial or distal, but not involving the incisal edge, on anterior teeth. Class 4 is mesial or distal involving the incisal edge on anterior teeth. We have class 5, that is a cervical lesion on any tooth, and class 6, which is the incisal edge or cusp tips on posterior teeth. So I hope you found this very quick summary of GV Black's classification useful. If you do have any suggestions for future videos, please make sure to leave a comment down below. If you did like this video, please make sure to like and subscribe. And until the next video, take care.